Okay, the subject, the topic for this video is Wien's law, and we'll be first talking about the spectrum of a black body, the spectrum of energy distribution of a black body, and then we'll try to understand the Wien's law. Okay. Let us first look at black body radiation. Black body radiation is considered a full radiation. We call it a full radiation. The reason, the meaning of the term full radiation is radiation consisting of all wavelengths, right? All wavelengths. So a black body radiates radiation of all wavelengths, and hence it's called a full radiation. And Lummer and Pringsheim, they studied the spectral distribution of energy. They studied the spectral distribution of energy for a black body. So they looked at how the energy of the radiation changes according to the different wavelengths, so which is known as spectral distribution of energy for a black body. And they used an experimental setup, and based on that they reached certain conclusions. So first let us have a look at the experimental setup used to get the spectral distribution of energy. The experimental setup looks something like this, right? Yes, I got it in the frame now. So we have a black body at a certain temperature T. So this is a black body. Actually, what was used was a electrically heated chamber with a narrow hole. So this would be the narrow hole through which radiation is coming out. There would be electric heated chamber over here, and the radiation that comes out of this chamber is considered black body radiation, because there's no way for this energy to escape. It keeps on reflecting within that chamber, and therefore it is considered a black body radiation. So this radiation comes out of this particular chamber through a small hole. It's made to fall on a mirror such that it gets reflected parallel, right? So the distance would, this distance would be the focal length of this particular mirror, so that the beam reflects parallel and then is made to fall on a prism. After refraction through the prism, the rays are again made to fall. The radiation is again made to fall on a mirror right over here. So here what has happened is it has got split into different wavelengths. For example, this over here will be d lambda. That means certain wavelength range, right? Whereas let me call it d lambda 1, because it's one range over here. Similarly, over here this would be another wavelength range. Let us call it d lambda 2. So this prism splits it into different wavelengths range, and different wavelength ranges are made to fall on this mirror M2, and the mirror M2 reflects them. You can see over here, right, this particular going in this particular direction nearly parallel to each other. Similarly, these two again going nearly parallel, right? If you trace these two lines, nearly parallel, and then they're made to fall on a thermopile, right? They're made to fall on a thermopile. So what happens is that the thermopile takes the radiation of this particular wavelength, right? And that is shown over here as a reflection in terms of current, and we are able to measure the energy, the E lambda. We are able to measure this, we will measure E lambda, right? The current over here will be able to give us an idea of E lambda. That means the energy of the radiation of a particular wavelength range, D lambda 1. Similarly, when I make this particular wavelength, this particular D lambda 2 incident on this, I'll get E lambda 2. So I get different, so I'll get E lambda 1, I get E lambda 2 as I make these particular d lambdas, that is wavelength ranges, fall on this thermopile and measure the value of current. So I get different values of e lambda 1, e lambda 2 for different wavelengths. And what was done was this: these values of e lambda 1, e lambda 2 for different wavelength ranges were obtained at different temperatures. So the black body temperature was changed, and again e lambda 1, e lambda 2 were measured. And as a result of this experiment, what we got was a spectral distribution curve which looked something like this. right? This is a spectral distribution curve, right? So we are having E lambda, that is, this is E lambda is the radiant energy for a given particular wavelength range, and this is the wavelength, right? Okay, and we got a spectral distribution curve, and then the spectral distribution curve was studied, right? As you can see, the spectral distribution curve is obtained at different temperatures. So this is temperature T1, T2, T3, T4, and T4. And as we go up, the temperature is rising. So E lambda versus lambda for different wavelength ranges. And if we study this spectral distribution curve, we can reach a few conclusions, right? Let me write those conclusions somewhere over here. Okay, let me get back this page and let me see if I'm able to squeeze in both the pages over here. Okay, maybe this is good enough. Okay. So the conclusions that we can draw from this particular spectral distribution curve are, okay, let me write E lambda so that's visible over here, E lambda. For the first conclusion that we can draw is, let me write the first conclusion over here, is that for a given temperature range, what we observe is that E lambda increases and then decreases, right? It reaches the maximum value and then decreases. So for a given temperature, E lambda increases, reaches a maximum value, and then decreases. That's the first and obvious conclusion that we can draw from this particular graph. Okay. What do we see? The other conclusion that can be drawn is that as the temperature rises, okay, the second conclusion that I can draw is as the temperature rises, the value of lambda m, that is the value of lambda for which we get the maximum value of E for a given curve, keeps on shifting towards the lower values of lambda. So what I'm observing over here is that as the temperature of the black body rises, as the temperature of the black, but the peak of the distribution curve, this is the peak of the distribution curve, shifts towards the shorter wavelength. It's shifting towards the shorter wavelength. That is, the maximum value of E lambda is obtained at lesser values of lambda. The maximum value of E lambda is being obtained at smaller and lesser values of lambda. And as the temperature rises, the maximum value of E lambda is obtained at lesser wavelengths or shorter wavelengths, right? And this particular observation is can be written in a mathematical form. In fact, Wien's observed this, he made this observation, and he gave the mathematical representation as lambda m into T is equal to B, where B is a constant. So what he was saying is that the maximum value of actually lambda m is not the maximum value, it is the value of lambda at which we get the maximum value of E lambda, right? So this could be a little bit confusing. Let me repeat this. Lambda m is not, this m is maximum, but it is not the maximum value of lambda. It is that value of lambda at which we get the maximum value of E lambda, right? So what he observed was that lambda m into T is a constant, right? Or in other words, lambda m and T are inversely proportional, which is quite obvious. As temperature increases, lambda m keeps on decreasing because we get the value of E lambda at lower values of lambda. So this is known as Wien's displacement law, right? And the value of B turns out to be 2.9 into 10 raised to -3 meter Kelvin. This is meter, and this is Kelvin. 2.9 into 10 raised to -3 Kelvin. And this equation is known as Wien's displacement law. And the statements can be written as the temperature of a black body increases, right, as it increases. The maximum energy radiation moves towards the shorter wavelength. We can see real life applications of this, and we can make a lot of reach a lot of conclusions out of this. One thing that we can conclude is that at lower temperatures, right, lambda m will be higher. That means at what we can conclude is that at lower temperatures, longer wavelengths are emitted. So at lower temperature, longer wavelengths are emitted, and when the temperature of an object rises, increases, shorter wavelengths are emitted. This is one of the conclusions that can be drawn from Wien's displacement law. Okay, and that's the second conclusion. The third conclusion, or third observation from this that we have, is that this area below, the area enclosed by the E lambda versus lambda graph is total energy, is the total radiant energy, total energy radiated, right? Or radiant emittance, right? Total energy radiated. And when the areas enclosed by different curves are measured, when I measure the areas enclosed by different curves, right, it is found that they are proportional to the fourth power of temperature. So I write over here, E is proportional to T raised to the power 4. Let us look at this. Let us understand this. If I take the area below this graph, I am going to get the value of E, the total energy radiated, right? And when I take areas below all the graphs one after the other, I find that E is directly proportional to fourth power of temperature, right? That's another conclusion that is obtained from this graph. And this last one, that the value of E lambda max, right? Over here we had taken E, right? Now we are taking of E lambda max. That means for example for this particular graph, this is E, this value is E lambda maximum. For this particular graph, this value is E lambda maximum. For this graph, this is E lambda maximum. For this is E lambda maximum. And similarly for this, E lambda maximum is equal. This value of E lambda maximum, it was proved by Wien that it is proportional to T raised to the power 5. Right? We'll make a distinction over here. Here this is the value of E, which is obtained by taking the area below the graph, right? And that is proportional to T raised to 4. Where the maximum value of E lambda is proportional to T raised to the power 5. And the meaning that comes out of this is that as we raise the temperature, the maximum energy, that is E lambda m, emitted corresponding to a given wavelength increases very, very rapidly. Because if I increase the temperature, say, two times, right, then if I increase the temperature two times, then E lambda maximum would increase 2 raised to the power 5 times, right? 2 raised to the power that 5 times, and that would be how much? That would be how much? 32 times. So just by increasing the temperature twice, 2 times, the E lambda maximum value increases 32 times. So it increases very rapidly. These are some of the conclusions that are drawn from spectral distribution curve for black body radiation. I hope that you have got some idea about the spectrum of black body radiation and Wien's law. In the next video, we will look at Stephen Boltzmann's law for black body radiation.